Hello students, let us re-enter the world of numbers. Well, today we are going to study the chapter square and square roots, in which first of all we will study square numbers. So to understand square number, let us take an example of suppose 3. When we multiply 3 with 3, means 3 into 3, it gives you 9. That 9 is a square number. Or if you take 5, 5 into 5 is 25. That 25 is again a square number. It means it is clear that when we multiply a number with itself, we are getting a square numbers. Or you can say square numbers are those numbers what we are getting when we multiply the number with itself. These square numbers follow some specific properties. Let us understand these properties of square numbers using this chart. This chart is showing the square of some whole numbers starting from 1. You can see square of 1 is 1. Square of 2 is 4, similar way of 3 is 9, and of other numbers are given in this chart. Now, when we study these square numbers, we see just if a number ends with 1, just as 1, 11, 21. You see their square numbers ends with 1. Means 1 square is 1, 11 square is 121, and 21 square is 441. So we can see that if a number have 1 as unit digit, its square number also will end with, means its last digit also will be 1. Similar way, one more number in this chart you can see, if last digit of a number is 9, just as 9, 19. Their squares have 1 as their unit digit. Means if you study thoroughly, you can see that if a number have their unit digit as 1 or 9, their squares also have their unit digit 1 only. Now, similar way, if a number ends with 2 or 8, in both the places, their squares are ending with 4. If a number ends with 3 or 7, their squares are ending with 9 only. You can see 7 square is 49, 3 square is 9, so they are ending with 9. If a number ends with 3 or 7, their squares are ending with 9. Similar way, if a number ends with 4 or 6, they ends with the digit 6 only. You can see 14 square is 196, 16 square is 256. In wherever the number have the 4 or 6 as their unit place, their squares will end with 6 only. So let us conclude that when the numbers have their unit digit 1 or 9, their squares are ending with 1. If the numbers are ending with 2 or 8, their squares are ending with 4. If the numbers are ending with 3 and 7, their squares are ending with 9. If the numbers are ending with 4 and 6, their square numbers are ending with 6. And the last one, if the number ends with 5, their last digit remains 5 only. So let us conclude. No square, no, if we see the square numbers, their union digits are either 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9. So this can from here we can come to the conclusion that there are no such number square numbers which are ending with 2, 3, 7 and 8. It means no square numbers end with 2, 3, 7 or 8. Means if you see any number whose unit digit is 2, 3, 7 or 8, you can clearly say that they are not at all square numbers. Now come to another property of square number. You can say that is a simple trick. It is regarding added triangular numbers. Triangular number. What are triangular numbers? You must know that. Just observe this pattern. Actually, this is one kind of pattern which I have shown with the help of these dots. One can be represented by a single dot. Now, here comes 3. 3 is represented by 3 dots. If you see, the shape is almost is making a triangle. Similar way, take 6. 1, 2, 3. This is also giving a shape of a triangle. Similar way, 10 is shown by one dot, then next 2, then 3, then 4 dots, and it is also making a shape of triangle. So 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, these are triangular numbers. So let us understand one more property of square numbers using triangular numbers. Let us see, when we add 1 and 3, you know 1 and 3 both are triangular numbers. So when we add 1 with 3, means first of all take 3 with 3 dots, then 1 with single dot. You see, you are having 4 dots now, which represents 4, and 4 is a square number. Let us take one more example, adding 3 and 6. This is 6, this is representing 6, and this is representing 3. If you count all the dots, you see, you have total, means in all you have 9 dots. And 9 again is a square number. So you can say, if you add any 2 consecutive triangular number, it gives you a square number. Another property of square number is adding of odd numbers. It means square of any number can be represented as a sum of any 2 consecutive odd numbers. Or you can say, when we add any 2 consecutive odd numbers, it gives you a square number. Just as when we add 1 with 3, 1 and 3 are 2 consecutive odd numbers. When we add 1 and 3, we are getting 4. Here, 4 is the square of 2, you can see. Now, if you add 3 consecutive odd numbers, just as 1, 3 and 5, you are getting the sum 9. Here, 9 is the square of 3. Similar way, by adding 1, 3, 5 and 7, we get 16. And 16 is the square of 4. From this we conclude, if numbers of odd numbers is represented by n, it means just here if we add 1 and 3, here are 2 odd numbers. If we add 1, 3 and 5, we have 3 odd numbers. So n represents the odd numbers, number of odd numbers we are adding. Then If numbers of odd numbers is represented by n, then sum of n odd numbers is n square. Means when we have added only one number, that is 1, with nothing, means 1 itself, it is the square of 1. When we are adding two odd numbers, we are getting square of 2. When we are adding three odd numbers, we are getting square of 3. Similar way, when we will have n odd numbers, it will give the square of n, that is n square. Now come to another property of square number, that is sum of consecutive natural numbers. Sum of consecutive natural numbers. Let means any square number, any square number means odd square number, you can say any odd square number can be represented by the sum of two consecutive natural numbers. Just as 3 square. 3 square is 9, and it can be expressed as the sum of 4 and 5. Similar way, square of 5 is 25, and that can be expressed as the sum of 12 and 13. Square of 7 is 49. 49 can be expressed as the sum of 24 and 25. So it concludes that square of any odd number can be expressed as the sum of two consecutive natural numbers.